Dobrodošli u crkvu Božju svima želim.
Welcome to God's house this Sabbath day.
Nadam se da ste došli ovde u crkvu Božju da sretnete Gospoda Isusa Hrista.
I trust that you will come here today to meet with God.
Da možda nađete neke odgovore na vaša pitanja.
And perhaps to find some answers to your questions.
A u svakom slučaju došli ste sa nekim očekivanjem.
But regardless of whatever, you've come no doubt with some sort of expectation.
Moja želja da Gospod zaista nahrani duše svih nas danas.
And my desire is that God will feed each and every one of us.
Iako ćemo možda malo proći kroz neku maglu,
and even though we may travel through some type of mist,
verujem da ćemo na kraju doći do svetla na lica našeg Gospoda.
Now I trust and believe that we will come to see the light of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay. Zadnjih dve, tri nedelje čini mi se da ste čuli da Severna Koreja preti da će Ameriku pretvoriti u prah.
No doubt over the last few weeks you've been aware of the news that is being said that North Korea is going to destroy the USA into the dust.
To isto preti Južnoj Koreji i Japanu.
It is also threatening South Korea and Japan.
Možete zamisliti u kakvom strahu sada žive te nacije.
Could you just imagine what sort of fear these nations live in at the moment?
Amerikanci s druge strane kažu da su sve opcije otvorene.
And on the other hand, the USA says that all options are open.
Severna Koreja kaže da je spremna za svaki rat i atomski rat.
And North Korea is announcing that it is prepared for any type of war.
I živci su, vidite, napeti.
The nerves are very tight at the moment.
Čeka se nešto.
All waiting for something.
Čeka se da neko izgubi živce.
Waiting for somebody to be unnerved.
I da prvi povuče katastrofalan potez.
And be the first to start the catastrophic war.
Biblija, čini mi se, ocrtava ovo vreme u kome mi živimo.
I tend to think that the Bible describes this type of period of time that we are living in.
Biblija nam pokazuje kakvo ćemo vreme mi svi doći.
The Bible tells us in what type of time we are going to live.
Kaže, ljudi će umirati od straha i od iščekivanja onoga što preti svetu, jer će se sile nebeske uzrmati.
It says, men's hearts will be failing them for fear, and the expectations of the things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken.
Kako je sa nama?
How is it with us?
Da li naše srce je malo uzbuđeno?
Are our hearts are trembling a little?
Možda se pitamo šta će biti sa ovim svetom?
Maybe we ask ourselves what on earth is going to happen to this earth?
I možda mnoga pitanja imamo u vezi toga.
And perhaps we have a lot of questions in this regard.
Kad govorimo o ratu,
when we speak of war,
skoro da nije bio period bez rata.
It seems that also there has never existed a period of time when wars have not existed.
Ono što vidimo jeste da je strah prisutan u svim međunarodnim odnosima.
What we are aware of is that there is fear amongst all nations.
Amerika je bacila majku svih bombi prošle nedelje, ili tako?
America dropped the mother of all bombs last week, we believe.
A Rusija opet imaju oca svih bombi.
And Russia has
oca svih bombi.
The Russia has the father of all bombs available.
Rusi se boje Amerike.
Russia is afraid of
America. Amerika se boji Rusije.
And America is afraid of Russia.
Ali izgleda da narode možemo da podelimo na dve grupe.
It seems though that we can divide nations in two groups.
Na one koji proizvode strah.
Those who create fear.
I na one koji su u strahu.
And those who are in fear.
Nije li to istina?
Is that true?
Upotreba sile.
The use of power.
I straha.
And fear.
Danas je dostigo takve razmere.
It's come to such a position today.
Da je zaprepastila i šokirala čak i one koji se služe i ratom i strahom.
It has even overcome and shocked those very people who are creating war.
Dakle, ljudi se pitaju ko je jači,
people are asking
vojno i ekonomski.
Asking which is stronger, the military or economic
istok
power.
Ili zapad?
The East or the West?
Ljudi misle da civilizacija zavisi od odgovora na ovo pitanje.
Civilization is thinking that perhaps the result, the destiny of civilization is depends on the correct answer to this question.
A kako ni istok ni zapad nisu sigurni u rešenje?
And when the east, if the east and west are not secure in the in what is going to happen.
Zato pretnja, strah,
threatening war.
I dalje haraju dakle svetom.
And they are threatening the world.
Kakav stav da mi zauzmemo u ovo posljednje vrijeme?
What should our position be in these last days?
Da li mi treba da drhtimo?
Should we be trembling?
Da li mi treba da se pitamo, hej, ko vodi ovu zemlju?
We to ask ourselves, well, who is in charge of this earth?
Koga da se uzdamo?
In whom should we trust?
Da li da se opredeljujemo za jednu silu ili drugu?
Should we trust in one power or should we trust in the other?
Kakav treba biti naš stav?
What should our position be?
Evo sada ćemo pročitati biblijski tekst, ako uspemo da pokrenemo PowerPoint.
We'll read a Bible text.
Hvala. Čućete za ratove.
You will hear of wars.
I glasine o ratovima.
And rumors of wars.
Šta kaže Gospod Isus?
And what does Jesus say?
Gledajte da se ne plašite.
See that you are not troubled.
A dve stvari nam kaže.
Tells us two things.
To mora da se dogodi.
This has to come to pass.
Zašto mora, to je drugo pitanje.
And why, that is another question.
Ali ono vrlo važno jeste, to nije kraj.
But something that is important, it says, but the end is not yet.
Dakle, ljudi u ovom svetu misle ako dođe do rata, šta znam, istoka i zapada, to je kraj civilizacije.
People in this world are thinking perhaps that if it comes to war, then civilization will be extinguished.
Ali onaj koji nam je dao ovaj stih,
but the person who has given us this verse,
on zna bolje od nas.
He knows better than
anyone.
I on
zna odgovor.
And he knows the answer.
I ovo je za nas vrlo važno.
And this is very important for us.
Vrlo je zanimljivo kako kad pogledate svet, nigde ne računa na Boga.
When we observe the world, it's interesting that nobody seems to be considering God.
Ove sile dakle planiraju kako će osvojiti svet, kako da vladaju nad svetom.
These powers are interested in how they're going to rule the world.
Ali su potpuno bezbožne.
But they are without God.
Uopšte ne uzimaju u obzir Boga, Božje postojanje i Božje neke planove.
They do not take into consideration God, God's plans and what his interest is for the future.
I zato kad slušate šta govore, razmišljajte da to govore ljudi koji Boga ne poznaju.
And so, when you think of these things, think that these are people who are saying these things and not God.
Možda neki od njih idu u crkvu.
Maybe some of them go to church.
Ali ne znam kakva im je to vera kada isključuju Boga iz svojih planova.
But I cannot understand it how they do not consider God in their plans.
I zato vidite, mi kao hrišćani imamo šta da naučimo od Božje reči.
You see how we as Christians have something to learn.
Evo ja želim sada da vam pokažem gdje je Božje mesto u istoriji čovečanstva.
I want to show you where God's place is in history of humanity.
Šta Bog dakle otkriva nama?
What God reveals to us.
Evo dakle Psalm 115:3 kaže: Bog je naš na nebesima.
Psalms 115:3, but our God is in the heaven.
Dakle, primetite prvo, on je na nebesima, što znači da je uzvišena sila i slava.
Take note, he is in the heavens, he is above all, he's the power that is above all.
I primetite, on tvori sve što hoće.
And what else? He does whatever he pleases.
On je moćan.
He is powerful.
I ono što planira.
And that what he plans.
On je kadar i da učini.
He is able and will do.
Kakva sigurnost?
What security is that?
To je zaista nešto predivno.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Evo Psalm 33, 10 i 11 kaže sljedeće.
Psalms 33:10 and 11 says.
Gospod razbija namere neznabožcima.
The Lord brings the counsel of the nations to nothing.
On uništava pomisli narodima.
He makes the plans of the peoples of no effect.
A pogledajte šta se čini sa Božjim namerama.
And what is happening with God's thoughts?
Námere Gospodne večno postoje i večno će
stajati. With His counsel, the counsel of the Lord stands forever.
Ovo je jedno neverovatno Božje otkrivenje.
This is quite an amazing revelation of God.
Bog je kadar da razbije namere nezlobožaca.
God is able to destroy the plans of those of the ungodly.
Postoje nažalost ljudi, umovi koji mrze čovečanstvo i čoveka i želeli bi da unište život.
Unfortunately, there does exist thinking that wants to destroy humanity.
Dakle, Amerika i Rusija ima toliko atomskih bombi da mogu da potpuno unište jedan drugoga.
Now, Russia and America have so many bombs that they are able to destroy the world.
Ali sa tim oružjem mogu da unište potpuno život na ovoj zemlji.
They're capable of ruining, of killing off each other as nations, but also to destroy the world.
Preživjeli bi samo neki mikrobi.
Some sort of microbes may be the only thing that would end up in existence.
Ali Bog uništava pomisli narodima.
But God brings the counsel of the nations to nothing.
A Boži plan sa ovom zemljom,
but God's plan for this world
u Božim rukama,
is in God's hands.
To je vest za nas danas.
That is the news for us today.
I to je vest, dakle, koje ovaj svet treba čuti također.
And this is the news that the world is also should hear.
Psalam 47 kaže, Bog caruje nad narodima.
Psalms 47:8 said, God reigns over the nations.
Nad kim Bog caruje?
Upon whom? Who does he reign?
Nad narodima.
On the nations.
I šta čitamo dalje? Bog sedi na svetom prestolu svom.
And we read further, God sits on his holy throne.
Dakle, Božja vladavina uključuje i ovu zemlju.
Now God's rule is also includes this world.
Pojedine nacije.
Particular individual nations.
Posebno one, dakle, koji imaju moćno oružje da razore maltene zemlju.
Particularly those nations that have the power to destroy this world.
Dakle, bez obzira šta se dešava, znajmo da je Bog na prestolu.
Regardless of what is occurring, we
ništa
know that God is on his
throne. Ništa ne
može
da se dogodi, a da nije Bog dopustio sa nekom namerom bilo šta da se dogodi.
Nothing has happened that God hasn't allowed with a particular purpose.
I bilo šta što bi došlo na crkvu, nije došlo dok Bog nije dozvolio da to dođe.
And in regardless of what may happen in the church, that nothing has occurred without God's
dakle,
approval.
Uzdajmo se u našeg Boga.
Now we need to trust in our God.
I pogledajte šta je vest za nacije i za svet.
And let's take a note of what the news is and for the people,
to bi se trebalo pročitati možda u Ujedinjenim nacijama.
Maybe this should be read to the UN.
Psalm 96:10.
Psalms 96:10.
Dakle, primetite, recite narodima.
Take note, it says, say amongst the nations.
Šta da kažemo?
What?
Gospod caruje.
The Lord reigns.
Zato je vasiljena ili zemlja tvrda i neće se pomestiti.
The world also is firmly established. It shall
ali
not be moved.
Ali također on će suditi narodima.
But he shall judge the peoples righteously.
Dakle, to je ono što je najvažnije da znamo.
That is the most important thing for us to know.
Bog će suditi narodima.
God will judge his people, judge the people righteously.
Bog će im dozvoliti da rade neko zlo.
God may allow them to do some evil.
Kako da im sudi ako im ne dozvoli da čine zla?
How can God judge the nations if he does not allow them to behave the way they want to?
Ali svet je u Božoj ruci.
But the world is in God's hands.
Božja crkva je u Božoj ruci.
God's church is in God's hands.
Tvoj i moj život je u Božoj ruci.
Your life and my life is in God's hands.
Ako predajemo svoj život u njegove ruke.
And if we should give our lives over to him, into his hands.
Dakle, još jedan put čitamo Danilo 4. glava 35. i 37. stih.
Daniel 4:35 and 37.
Ovako Nabuhodonosor koji se obratio Bogu kaže posle toga.
And this is what Nebuchadnezzar says after he was converted.
Pogledajte šta on kaže.
What he says.
Ma svi stanovnici zemaljski ništa nisu prema njemu, Bogu.
All inhabitants of the earth are reputed as nothing.
Dakle, šta su sve ove atomske svetske sile?
All of these atomic powers.
Kaže tekst, ništa su pred Bogom.
The text says this is nothing, as nothing before God.
Bog radi što god hoće sa vojskom nebeskom i sa stanovnicima zemaljskim.
God does according to his will in the army of heaven and among the inhabitants of the earth.
Nema nikoga da mu ruku stavi i rekao mu šta radiš.
No one can restrain his hand or say to him, what have you done?
Bog je apsolutist, kao što vidite.
God is absolute.
Ne može niko da mu kaže šta radiš.
Nobody can question and ask God, what are you doing?
Dakle, nikakvi zli ljudi.
Now, no evil people.
Nikakvi masoni.
No atoms.
Ni neke tamo, ne znam, ove istočne religije.
Oh, no other eastern religions.
Nikakvi demoni.
No demons.
Nikakav satana.
No Satan.
Ne može Božju ruku zaustaviti.
Cannot stop God's hand.
Uzdajte se u Božju reč, dragi moji.
Trust in God's word.
Verujte Bogu.
Believe God.
I pogledajte šta kaže Nabuhodonosor posle veoma gorkog iskustva.
And let's see what Nebuchadnezzar says after such a trialist experience.
Sada ja Nabuhodonosor hvalim, uzvišujem i slavi cara nebeskoga.
Now I Nebuchadnezzar praise and extol and honor the king of heaven.
Čija su sva dela istinita.
All of his works are truth.
I čiji su putevi pravedni koji može oboriti one koje hode ponosito.
And his ways justice. And those who walk in pride he is able to abase.
Dakle, primetite, svi Božji putevi su i dela istiniti.
Now take note that God's every action of God is truth.
Potpuno obara satanske optužbe protiv Boga, sećate se.
He can deflect all of Satan's accusations against
Ali
God.
Ali ovo je važno. But this is important. On može oboriti one koji hode ponosito.
His ways are just, and those who walk in pride, he is able to abase.
Take pogledajte nacije koje hode vrlo ponosito.
Oh, these nations here behave in a very proud way.
A ne znaju da zavise od Boga i Božje sile.
But they are not aware of God's power.
Pogledajte ko je naš Gospod.
Take
I kaže,
dve
slike
is.
Boga imamo u Isaiji 40. Poglavlju.
We have two pictures of God, one in Isaiah.
Hajde da čitamo prvo, Otkrivenje 19:16.
Let's first read Revelation 19:16.
Kaže da Hristos ima na haljini na stegnu svom ime napisano.
And he has on his robe and on his thigh a name written.
Car na carevima, gospodar nad gospodarima.
King of kings and Lord of lords.
I ima silnih careva na ovoj zemlji.
There are amazingly powerful rulers in this earth.
Ali Isus je car nad tim carevima.
But Jesus is king and above all of those he is king of kings.
I on je gospodar nad drugim gospodarima.
And he rules above all other rulers.
Jer vi znate da sve nacije u stvari gospodare. Bar sa nekim.
Well, you see that, as we know, that every nation is in control of somebody somewhere.
Dakle, prva slika o Bogu kaže s kim ćete dakle izjednačiti Boga.
Another picture of God says to whom then will you liken God?
Kako ćete mu priliku ili usporedbu naći?
Or what likeness will you compare to him?
Kakav je naš Bog?
How is our God?
Koja je to slika našeg Boga prva?
What is the picture of God?
Ovo je Božja pozicija, dakle.
This is God's position.
Ali sada, koja je to prva slika našeg Boga?
What is the first image of our God?
Hajde da vidimo Isaija 40:10.
In Isaiah 40:10.
Gle, vaš Gospod Bog dolazi u sili.
Behold, the Lord God shall come with a strong hand.
Mišicom svojom vlada.
And his arm shall rule for him.
Evo s njim naplata njegova.
Behold, his reward is with him.
A ispred njega njegova nagrada.
And his work before him.
Bog dolazi u sili.
God is coming in power.
To čovečanstvo treba da zna.
That is what humanity needs to know and we need to know.
Dakle, on vlada.
He is the ruler.
Iako možda mi ne vidimo kako on to vlada.
And even though we may not be able to see how he rules.
Moramo studirati malo Božje proviđenje da vidimo način kako Bog vlada sada.
We need to study God's and see how he is could be ruling right now.
U carstvu milosti.
In the kingdom of mercy.
A čekamo carstvo slave.
And we are waiting for the kingdom of glory.
Koje će doći njegovim dolaskom.
Which will come when he comes.
On dakle će naplatu nekima dati.
His reward will be given to some.
A drugima nagradu.
And he will reward his reward with his, is with him and his work before him.
Da, mala razlika, yeah. Plata i kazna. That's okay. Sve zavisi od toga šta te
depends.
Nacije rade.
It all depends on what these nations are doing.
Sve zavisi od toga šta uopšte čovjek radi.
It all depends on what
Jer, evo vidite, Hristov dolazak može biti radostan trenutak, a može biti vrlo gorak i žalostan.
Christ's coming can be a joyous event or it can be a bitter
event.
Od nas
zavisi kako će biti Hristov dolazak za nas.
It depends upon us how Christ's coming
will be to us. Ali evo Isaija govori o drugoj slici našeg Boga.
But there's another image of God.
Kaže, kao pastir, tako on pase stado svoje.
Like a shepherd, he will feed his flock.
Jagnjad uzima u naruče svoje.
He will gather the lambs with his
arms. Nosi ih na prsima svojim.
And carry them in his bosom.
A polako vodi dojilicu ovcu.
And gently lead those who are with young.
Druga slika našeg Boga je pastir svoga stada.
Another image of God is as a shepherd.
Dakle, primetite, jagnjad uzima u naručje.
You'll take notice that he gathers the lambs in his arms.
Bebe i našu malu decu Gospod uzima u naručje.
And the children, you and me, the children gathers them in his arms.
Nosi ih na prsima svojim. Primetite kako
gathers
to
them into his bosom.
Duboki odnos, ljubav.
What a deep loving relationship.
Pogledajte koliko je uviđavan Bog. Polako vodi dojilicu ovcu.
How careful and caring is our God. He gently leads those who are with young.
Ne šiba ovcu.
He doesn't get out the stick and hits them.
Sasvim polako je prilagodio i svoj hod prema toj maloj.
Slowly and gently, and he adjusts the way he walks, his pace according to the pace of the little ones.
Biblija kaže da smo mi Hristove ovce.
And the Bible tells us that we are Christ's sheep.
Kad sam prvi put došao u crkvu našu.
When I first came to our church.
I pastor govori, mi smo ovce Hristove.
And when the pastor said, we are the Christ's sheep.
Nekako nisam to volao.
No, I sort of didn't like that.
Neću da budem ovca.
I don't want to be a sheep.
Kakva je to slika ja ovca?
What sort of a picture is that? I'm a sheep.
Ali kasnije kad sam video ko je pastir.
But then later as I realized who the shepherd is.
Onda sam rado izabrao da budem ovca Hrista.
And then I was quite happy to select to
be choose
to
Bog,
be a sheep of Christ.
Na prestolu svemira postao je jagnje Božje za nas.
Now we know that the God of heaven became a sheep.
Ima li tu nekog ponižavanja ako budem Hristova ovca?
Is there anything for me to be ashamed of if I am Christ's sheep?
Znate u Psalmu 23:1.
Psalm 23:1.
Gospod je pastir moj.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Ali na jevrejskom kaže Jehova, Jehova je pastir moj.
But in Hebrew it says Jehovah is my shepherd.
Svemogući Bog je moj pastir.
The Almighty God is my shepherd.
Pa neću biti lud da bežim iz te pozicije. Well, rado hoću da budem njegova ovca.
Then it would be foolish of me to run away from the position of being his sheep. I will gladly be his sheep.
A Isus je u Jovanu 10 kazao, ja sam dobri pastir.
And in John 10 Jesus said, I am the good shepherd.
Ja polažem život ili dušu moju za ovcu.
I sacrifice my life, my soul for the sheep.
Takvog pastira volim.
What an amazing person.
I vrlo rado ga prihvatam da bude moj pastir.
And I'm quite happy to accept him to be my shepherd.
Jer to je samo slika njegove brige i ljubavi prema svojoj ovci.
Because that is the illustration of his care and his love towards me.
Da li vi prihvatate da budete Hristova ovca?
Do you accept to be Christ's sheep?
Imao sam u Bandebergu jednog starešinu, svaki put kad bi se obraćao crkvi,
I had an elder in a church that I was serving, and every time he came to church,
on ih je nazivao stado.
He would call the church my flock.
Flock. Je. U engleskom to lepo zvuči, možda na našem stado.
In English, it's not a derogatory term, but in the other language, it can be.
Ja vam još jedanput kažem, to je uzvišena pozicija svakog od nas da budemo u Hristovom stadu.
But I would emphasize that it is an elevated position for us to be part of God's flock.
Ne zaboravite, ostavio 99 ovaca.
Remember the shepherd left the 99 sheep?
Da bi spasio ovu jednu koja se izgubila.
to save the one that was lost.
Hoću da budem njegova ovca.
I want to be Christ's
sheep. A on
sheep.
Kaže, ja izabrah vas.
And he says, I have chosen you.
Dakle, dve slike Boga.
There are two images of God.
Jedna je biti pastir,
one
a druga
is to
je,
be the shepherd.
Dakle, Bog koji dolazi kao sudija.
And the other is God is coming as a judge.
I zato mi moramo da odlučimo šta ćemo, gde ćemo.
And then we are, the decision is up to us where we will be found.
Naš Gospod Isus je gospodar naroda.
Our Jesus Christ is the ruler of all nations.
Moram žuriti pošto ovo vreme ide.
I must speed up because time is
pa
getting
away.
Pa
šta su ove nacije atomske kakve god u odnosu na Boga. Hajde da vidimo to.
Now, what are these nations, atomic or whatever, in comparison to God? Let's have a look.
Broj jedan što nam kaže Isaija 40:15.
In Isaiah 40:15.
Moćne nacije kao kap vode.
Behold, the nations are as a drop in a bucket.
Dakle, gle, narodi su kao kap iz kofe.
See, behold, the nations are as a drop in a bucket.
Kap.
Drop.
Šta je kap?
What is a drop?
Jedna kap. Dobro, više pa nešto vredi, ali jedna.
One drop. Maybe if there were more, well some
šta
have
kap
but one.
Može da po učini?
What can a drop achieve?
Primetite drugo, ta kap je u ovome u kofi.
Now, could you take notice of what is left in the bucket?
Onaj ko nosi kofu, on može da radi s njom šta hoće.
The one who is holding the bucket can do whatever he wishes with
pa
the contents.
Pa šta su ti narodi, moćni, silni?
But what are you nations, mighty and strong?
Samo su kap only iz jedne obične kofe.
You are only as a drop in an ordinary bucket.
Ne zaboravite dakle ovaj da pogledajte našeg Boga suprotno ovome kap.
Let's just take note of what God is in relation, in opposition to this drop.
On je šakom izmerio mora i meru neba odredio pedljem.
Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand? They're talking about God.
Šakom je izmerio mora.
He's measured heaven.
Kako mi da izmerimo mora, vodu na ovoj zemlji?
He's measured the waters in the hollow of his hand.
On je i gore ili planine izmerio na merila.
And he's calculated the dust of the earth in a measure. He weighed the mountains in scales.
I bregove na poteg njihov.
And the hills in a balance.
Dakle, prema onim nacijama koje su kao kap.
In comparison to these nations are just like a drop.
Bog je veći od svih okeana,
God is
jezera,
larger
reka zajedno.
Than any ocean, lake or mountain.
I sve ti okeani i jezera i ove reke
and all of those mountains, lakes and rivers.
Samo za Boga su kao jedna kofa vode.
For God is just like holding a bucket
I možda
with
radi
water
s njima šta god hoće.
And he can do whatever he wishes.
Primetite tu veličinu našega Boga.
Now just take note of the might and the greatness of our God.
Šta su ove moćne armije, moćne nacije ovoga sveta?
And in comparison to these mighty, so-called mighty nations of this world.
Pogledajte šta kaže Božja reč. Ko je upravljao duh gospodnji ili mu bio savjetnik i naučio ga?
Who has directed the Spirit of the Lord or as his counselor has taught him?
S kim se dogovarao i koga je urazumio i naučio putu suda?
With whom did he take counsel and who instructed him and taught him in the path of justice?
Naš Bog je stvoritelj.
Our God is the creator.
On je mudar Bog.
He is a wise God.
I on brine o onome što je stvorio.
And he cares for that he has created.
Bog je zaista moćan.
God is surely mighty.
A šta su nacije ovoga sveta?
But what are the nations of this world?
Kaže ovde, kao prah na merilima broje se.
It says they are as a small dust on the balance.
I otoci, ove ostrva su mu kao zrno peska.
And the isles are as a very little thing.
Kao prah na merilima.
As the dust on the scales.
U staro vreme u apotekama ste imali ona merila, znate, i tamo. Mere i prahić.
In the old days, they used to measure in the pharmacies, there was a balance. And they would measure out the medicines accordingly.
I šta
on the
radi tamo sa onim prahom?
And if there was a bit of dust on the balance, what would he
samo
do?
Samo dune.
He would blow it
i
off.
Taj prah ode.
And that dust would disappear.
Dakle, šta su nacije ovoga sveta prema Bogu?
Well, what are the nations in comparison
samo prah.
To God? Only as dust.
Ko malo zrce peska.
As a small, very little thing as sand.
Ako razmišljamo o sili Bože.
if we are comparing to the strength and might of God.
Ovde se ne radi samo o sili.
This is not only to do with the strength and might.
Dakle, imamo li razloga da se bojimo nekih nacija i nekih planova koje oni imaju?
Then do we have any reason to fear these nations and their threats?
Bog je naš. God, kao što vidimo, moćni i slavni.
God is our God is mighty.
Otoci su mu kaže kao zrno peska.
He lifts up the isles as a very little thing. It is like a grain of sand.
Very little thing, što kaže. Veoma mala stvar. Ništa.
A very small thing.
Dakle, Bog može rešiti situaciju u svetu.
Now God can solve the situation of the world.
Tako lako.
So simply.
Ko kad mi uzmemo jedan kamenčić i bacimo ga.
As if to get a small stone and throw it.
I Bog će ispuniti svoje planove i ciljeve.
And God will fulfill his plans for this world.
Hajmo da vidimo još jednu treću sliku, kakvi su narodi.
Now a third picture of what the nations are in comparison
to God. Ne samo ove dve svetske sile.
Not just those two
kaže,
world powers.
Kaže, svi narodi zajedno.
It says all nations all together.
Kao ništa su pred njim.
Before him are as nothing.
Šta je to ništa?
What is nothing?
Zula, nula.
Nothing.
Ništa su pred njim.
They are nothing compared
možda
to God.
Možda niste imali takvu sliku o Bogu.
Many didn't have that picture of God.
Možda su nam se kolena tresla pred nekom silom.
Maybe we were trembling at the knees before such nations.
Sve nacije.
All nations.
Zajedno, sve zajedno.
All together.
Ma ništa su pred njim.
And nothing compared to God.
Hvala Bogu za ovo otkrivenje.
Thank you God for this
veoma
revelation.
Je utešno za nas.
It's very comforting for us.
Evo Isaija 40:17 stih kaže sljedeći.
And Isaiah 40:17 says the following.
Svi su narodi kao ništa pred njim.
All nations before him are as nothing.
On ih drži za ništa i ništavne.
And he holds them and they are counted by him less than nothing and worthless.
On ih drži da su ništa i ništavne.
He says that they are less than nothing and worthless.
I zato nije čudo što nam Biblija kaže ne uzdajte se u knezove i u sinove čovečije.
And then it is no surprise, should be no surprise to us when the Bible tells us not to trust in kings and princes.
Dalje kaže Božja reč, on je onaj koji obraća knezove u ništa.
The Bible tells us he brings the princes to nothing.
Koji vladaoce zemaljske uništava.
He makes the judges of the earth useless.
Dakle, čini i da budu neupotrebljivi.
It means makes them to be unusable.
A kako je to vidljivo i u današnjem svijetu.
Yeah, that is obvious in today's world, isn't it?
Dakle, on je taj koji vlada i nad vladarima ove zemlje.
He is that the one who rules over the rulers of this earth.
I to je zaista ohrabrujuće za nas.
And that can be very encouraging for us.
On je veliki stvoritelj kao što čitamo.
He is the great creator.
On održava cijeli univerzum.
He upholds and holds the complete universe.
Mi poznajemo i vidimo nešto tako oko 25 milijardi svetlosnih godina.
We can see some sort of how many light years away.
I kad to gledamo zaista se divimo Bogu kao stvoritelju.
And we look at the universe and the creation amazes us.
Dakle, ljudi koji su protiv Boga, oni se bore protiv svemogućeg Boga.
And those who are against God are against everything.
A sada da izvučimo jednu poruku za nas.
And shall we just draw a lesson from this?
Dakle, Bog drži zvezde.
God holds up the stars.
Bog drži, kao što vidimo, istoriju ovoga sveta.
In his hands is the history of this world.
A šta je sa nama?
What about
Naša,
us?
Nama malima koji smo, pojedincima.
What about us, each individual?
Da li je Boga briga šta je se dešava s nama?
Each of us is a small individual. Does God care what happens to us?
I mi smo skloni da kažemo kao Izrael.
And we can be tempted to say as Israel.
Skrivena je sudbina moja, Gospodu.
My way is hidden from the Lord.
Dakle, mislimo da Bog ne zna za nas.
And maybe we feel that God is not unaware of us.
Mislimo da nas je možda zaboravio ili ne znam šta.
Perhaps that he's forgotten us or who knows what.
Možda mislimo da on ima preča posla da održava celi svemir, a ne da brine sad o meni jednom.
Maybe we consider that he has more important things to do by holding up the world than to consider us
ali
as individuals.
Ali Biblija daje ohrabrenje.
But the Bible encourages us.
Bog je spreman da govori sa nama nasamo.
God is prepared to speak to us as individuals.
Jedan na jedan, licem licu.
One to one, face to face.
Evo šta nam kaže.
Now what he says.
Ne znaš li, ne čuješ li?
Have you not known? Have you not heard?
Večni Bog je Gospod.
The everlasting God, the Lord.
Он є створитель краєва земальських.
The creator of the ends of the earth.
Он се не умара.
Neither faints.
Он не сустає.
Nor is weary.
Разуму Негову нема мере.
There is no searching of his understanding.
Дали знаєш, що Он каже? Дали чуєш?
He's saying, do you understand that? Do you hear?
Ако е то истина, онда мораш сватити да те волим.
If you understand that, then you must understand that I love you.
Ја сам твој пастир.
I am your shepherd.
И онда погледајте шта каже. Он даје снагу уморноме.
Take note of what he says. He gives power to the weak.
Ако си уморен, ако си данас дошао уморен, обрати се Богу. Он даје снагу уморноме.
If you've come here today tired and weary,
деца каже море се и сустају. И младичи падају.
Even the youth shall faint and be weary.
Бог брине и о деци.
God cares about
you. И о бебама, и оне славе Него, знате.
And the children praise him.
Дали се надамо у Богу? Дали се надамо у Богу?
Do we have faith and hope in God?
Дакле, дали е о наша нада?
Is God our hope?
Ево обећање за оне који имају наду у Богу.
Here is the promise of those who have hope in God.
Који се надају Господу.
But those who hope and wait on the Lord shall renew their God shall renew their strength.
Подижу се на крилима као орлови.
They shall mount up with wings like eagles.
Трче.
They shall run and not be weary.
А неки ходе и не море се.
And they shall walk and not
faint. Ми имамо овде људе који ето ходе, не могу да трче.
We have people here who can hardly walk, they can't run.
Мачни пар Михајловић позади не могу да трче.
There are some here that can't
run. Али
ходе
и не умарају се.
But God cares for them.
Али ми који трчимо дакле,
but those of us who run,
нећемо одустати.
We will not faint.
А некима ће Бог дати крила ентузијазма, вере, очекивања.
And God will give some those wings of enthusiasm.
И даје нам нову снагу.
And he give us a new life.
Па можемо ли да имамо поверење у такво?
Can we trust and have hope and trust in such a God?
Можемо ли да га волимо?
Are we able and should we can we love him?
Можемо ли да му предамо и наш мали живот?
Can we surrender our little life?
Да буде под његовом контролом и водством.
To be under his control and will.
Ако он сваку звезду зна по имену.
If he knows the name of each star.
И одржава је.
And maintains them.
А Господ каже, ма знам и тебе.
And God says, but I know you.
Знам и колко имаш број коса на глави.
I know the number of your the hairs on your head.
Све знам о тебе.
I know everything about you.
И знам твоје срце.
I know your heart.
Kako je s našim srcem?
How are our hearts?
Da li smo spremni dakle da predamo svoj život u Božje ruke?
Are we prepared to surrender our lives in God's
hands?
On
je jedina sigurnost našeg života.
He can be the only certainty of our lives.
Sudbina ovog sveta nije ni u Vašingtonu ni u Moskvi.
The fate of this world is not in the hands of the USA or Moscow.
Nego u Božoj ruci.
But in the hand of God.
Imamo li mi poverenje u tu ruku Božju?
Do we have trust and faith in God's
hands? Ne zaboravite ta ista ruka koja je stvorila.
Just remember that same hand that created.
Bila je razapeta na krstu.
Was crucified on the cross.
Za nas.
For us.
I danas njegova ruka je usmerena prema svima nama.
And God and today that same hand is extended out towards us.
Molim vas, predajte svoje živote u Božje ruke.
I plead that you surrender your lives into God's hands.
To je jedina sigurnost.
That is the only certainty we can have.
Neka je slava i čast našem Bogu.
May praise and honor be to God.
I sada i jednom u večnosti.
And for now and in it throughout eternity.
Amen.
Amen.
Oče nebeski.
Our Father in heaven.
Kako je utešna tvoja reč.
How comforting your word is.
Kako nam tvoja reč pokazuje tvoje veličanstvo i slavu.
How your word shows us displays your honor and your glory.
Kako si silan Bože u svemiru, a takođe i na ovoj zemlji.
You are a mighty God in the universe and on this earth.
Hvala ti na tom otkrivenju.
Thank you for that revelation.
Hvala ti što sada vidimo gde je mesto velikim nacijama ovoga sveta.
Thank you that we can now see the rightful positions of the great nations of this world.
Hvala ti, Gospode, što istoriju ovoga sveta držiš u svojim rukama.
We thank you, dear God, that you're holding the history of this earth in your hands.
Hvala ti što vodiš svoje planove ka svom cilju.
Thank you that you are your plans are going towards your goals.
I hvala ti, Gospode, što ćeš ispuniti dobru volju svoju nad nama svima.
We thank you that you are going to fulfill your will in our hearts.
Ti ćeš nas spasiti.
You are going to save us.
Ti si naš dobri pastir.
You are our good shepherd.
Koji je dao svoj život za nas.
Who has given his life for us.
I mi rado, Gospode, želimo da budemo deo tvoga stada.
And we so gladly want to be a part of
da nas
your
vodiš,
so you can guide us,
da nas hraniš,
that you can feed us,
da nas čuvaš,
that you can guide us,
i da nam daš život kako si obećao,
and to give us life as you have promised.
Hvala ti i slava na tom obećanju.
Thank you and glory be to you on
I
those promises.
I pomozi svima nama danas,
and help each and every one of us today,
da nam srce bude žarko prema tebi,
to have fire within our hearts towards
you, da imamo sigurnost u svom srcu,
to have certainty in our hearts,
jer se oslanjamo na tebe,
because we are leaning and depending upon you.
Hvala ti i slava.
Thank you and praise be to you, God.
I u silno i veliko ime Hristovo,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.